This is Praveen and Ayapan. We are from Chennai. This is our session, Drupal bot powered by Google AI, Drupal workflow automation. Generally, this is about Drupal bot to help to engage the content editors for content manipulations and the content creations. So let's go and check with this. This is our agenda. In that session, we are discuss about the introductions of the bots and benefits, and the introduction of the good bots and the bad bots, and how it works, and then how the bot could be a successful computing platform. And we are discuss about the verticals and dynamics of the bot platform ecosystems, and then how to integrate the Drupal 8 with the Google bot called Dialogflow model. Then we have to discuss about the implementation of a bot in Drupal 8. Then we discuss about the key challenges we are facing on the implementation. Then at last we can discuss about the feature works of this Drupal bot. Generally, bots is generally a small software programs. It can run repeatedly in a continuous manner. In the bot, we need to add a bot platform ecosystem. Ecosystems which can be deployed and interact with the users and perform actions on the behalf. Generally, Google bot and the Siri bot are the informational bots. Okay, these bots are only contains a knowledge in nature and then able to interact with the users. It can be helped with assistance. Will eventually invoke the bots to domain specific work. Next, introduction of bots and benefits. Bots are generally now bots are exposed now. We can develop a bot in Google called a Dialogflow model. I can show you the demo of the Dialogflow model, then you can understand. Dialogflow model from the Google is a bot platform ecosystem. It is just a framework, and then we discuss about we define the behavior of the bot, like Google Assistant bot had some characteristics and the Siri bot had some characteristics based on the security concerns. So we can define that characteristics in bot distinctions. These are the benefits of the bot, major benefits of the bot nowadays. Keep up with the trends. Generally, Twitter and Messenger engaged nearly millions of bots to engage with the users. And then it helps to improve the customer services and customer engagement and the monitoring and gaining the insights. This one helps for more engagement of the Google Analytics, not only Google Analytics, for analytic perspective. And then a better lead generation and bouncing rate of the web applications or mobile application. And then we can approach easier into the global market. At last, cost saving. Cost saving means literally we can tell as a TCO, total cost ownership, is less compared to others. These are the major benefits of the using the bot. And next one is the introduction of the good bot and how it works. We are mostly facing the good bot and the bad bot also. In good bots are, we all know the chat bots and crawlers. Chat bots is just a Google, like a Google Assistant and Siri. Like these are the chat bot, or we can go to any web application, there is a bot, a person can speak with you, or a bot can speak with you and interact with some other person with the company. And next one is the crawlers. Crawlers is a very good bot, because these are called web spiders. I think those people know about the web spiders. It can make an index of the web page, web application to the search engine like Google and Bing. Google and Bing has own bot called Google bot and Bing bot. And transactional bot, this is a very recently popular bot. A transactional bot is just enhances and provide a services to the external application, like third party applications, and make a data transfer with it. And the next one is the informational bot. Information bot is just had a knowledge in nature, like a Siri and Siri, they are chat bots. Information bots is means if you go to the web application, a bot can know something. Okay, these are the information bot. These are domain specific bots. I can tell domain specific bots. And entertainment bots are gaming bots, Many games have a bot. You can play as a opposite team, but it can virtually we can virtually f feel like a person can play with it. These are a bot. And bad bots are hackers, spammers, and scrappers and impersonators. These are we are facing when you download some application or some file in torrent, it redirect to some other pages. These are the bad bots. General examples of the bad bots. Our next one is how bot could be a successful computing platform. Generally, there are five paradigms are considered to be a successful computing platform. Those are the software foundation contains a rich set of API. And next one is the community developers who can contribute to the software or foundation. And next one is the distributions. Generally, we call it as distros. It can reach the multiple devices. And next one is the monetization. How can we monetize by developing applications or bots by using the software foundation? And next one is how can we retail the content? Like I can set you an example. Drupal is a simple example for the successful computing platform because it had a good stable releases and it had a good community. It had a good distros. And it is free, but we can develop our distributions and we can monetize this and make a retail of that content. Similarly, bot has evolved like this. These are the example of the successful computing platform, or I can tell it is a architecture or it is a standard for to be a best computing platform. The bot can act as interim between the content creation point and the content distribution control point. Here, software foundation like a platform APIs, software foundation, developer ecosystem, monetization, distributions, and retailing are the ingredients to the successful computing. In the successful computing, how the product success factors has been calculated by using how it has been managed in a fragmented manner and how it has been actively participate in the community and how it has been ubiquitous in manner and how it has been large addressable market. And the next one is the personalized discovery of applications. And next one is how it can tackle its competencies. That's the main thing. These are the standards for the successful computing platforms. These are the examples of the these are the example bots which can sustain the verticals and the dynamics of the bot platform ecosystem. Generally, we know most of the things, right? WeChat, we know, and Facebook Messenger, Microsoft Skype. Microsoft Skype is recently introduced, but and Telegram is recently introduced, and Slack bot and Facebook Messenger and WeChat are in earlier stage. They are the pioneer for this. And next one, we got introduction of the Drupal 8 and the Google Bot Dialog Flow. Generally, Dialog Flow is a Google AI bot. It is a Google AI platform which helps to create a bot without code. We don't need to write a code for simple things. If you go to IBM Watson or some other bot, means we need to write a code for this. Generally, Dialog Flow is a natural language processing model. It is a conversational platform which can interact with the user by using some configuration intents. Why the Dialog Flow is most popular means because if I go to develop a bot for the Facebook Messenger, means I can use only for the Facebook Messenger. If I go to develop a bot for Slack, means I can do only for Slacks. But if I develop a bot using the Dialog Flow, I can integrate those into all. For Messenger, for Slack bots, and any interfaces. I can integrate those. These are the Dialog Flow process pipelines. In Dialog Flow process pipelines, it had certain factors like intents. Intents means just user utterances, what the user input and Dialog Flow has to provide output. It had some pipelines like context, events, actions and params, response and fulfillment. In context, it is just user utterances, and events means what events when trigger for this input. And actions and params means these are the dynamic values. If you are handle the dynamic value means we have to give actions and params. Responses and fulfillment means in fulfillment you just log the data. In responses means for this context, for this event, for this intent, what is the responses? So these are the implementations of the bot with the Drupal. Generally, an user in the Drupal application, a user can provide a input. That is a user-based preferred utterances or actions, and then intents. Intents are just a intentional user intention words. It's intents, and then process means this is dialogue flow process pipelines. In the process, we already know context, events, actions and params, responses and fulfillment. Then we can integrate with webhook responses, and then webhook responses we trigger the event in the Drupal application. We implemented in the process flow. We are not implemented in the webhook integrations. These are the actual workflow in this model. In the Drupal application, a user can ask a bot to create a node. In the bot, ask us which node type you want to create. Then we have tell us a basic page. Then it has been redirected to the page. Basic page as an entity and the node as an entity. Creation page. The same process will be for all the Drupal configurations and the content entities. Then it is what are the achievement is it provides a more realistic compared to the other bots and self improvement capabilities in Dialogflow we have to pay for that. These are free. These are the complex phases in implementation because we can't find the intent naming for all the user intention, and we cannot change the existing process in the chatbot using the dialogue flow, and we cannot leverage the existing data in the dialogue flow, and the format flow complexities are there, and then ML model non-determinization means we have to employ the machine learning phase and the TensorFlow phase or the deep learning phase to learn better the Drupal application because it helps to content editors to put their content. It just navigate the content editors for thus create a node like a basic page means you just command them, it just navigate to the that page, they put their content. The content editors no need to know about the navigations. These are the significance of this presentation, this idea. And these are the feature works. If it continues means because we are working on this, it works only for end user and the editors or content providers. Now a Drupal developer can use this bot. A Drupal developer can develop a Drupal application using this bot. And the main phase is the bot can work for a developer. This is the main phase. And it can integrate with it. And the next phase is it can integration with the Drupal application for continuous integration, continuous deployment means a bot can do all the things when developer commands to the bot. And next is it has to be improvises the content editor's workflow as well as the Drupal developer workflow. So now I show you a demo. Next, in Drupal Chennai, we had an event on December 7 or 8. We are the volunteers. We welcome you all. So I show you a demo. This is the Drupal bot. This is the Drupal application. We are integrating the dialogue flow context. Wait. This is the dialogue flow interface. In that interface, we had a intent named default welcome intent. In that intent, we specify the welcome message. These are the training, in the training phases we provide what are the user will ask, what are the user utterances will be. For hi, he will call as just going to say hi. We just provide a general training for the bot, and then we provide a responses here. Here, these are the responses when you ask these type of questions. It will reply like this. These are the three intents we are created. In that intent, this is the welcome note. This is the fallback note. Fallback intent means it just no, it doesn't know the correct intent. Means it just show like exceptions, and it is the default Drupal welcome intent we are just now created. If I go there. Just to provide a reply only. That's we are implemented. That's it. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, this is Praveen and Ayappan. We are from Chennai. This is our session Drupal bot powered by Google AI, our Drupal workflow automation. Generally, this is about a Drupal bot to help to engage the content editors for content manipulations and the content creations. So let's go and check with this. This is our agenda. In that session, we are discuss about the introductions of the bots and benefits, and the introduction of the good bots and the bad bots and how it works, and then how the bot could be a successful computing platform. And we discuss about the verticals and dynamics of the bot platform ecosystems, and then how to integrate the Drupal 8 with the Google bot called Dialogflow model. Then we have to discuss about the implementation of a bot in Drupal 8. Then we discuss about the key challenges we are facing on the implementation. Then at last we can discuss about the feature works of this Drupal bot. Generally, bots is generally a small software programs. It can run repeatedly in a continuous manner. In the bot, we need to add a bot platform ecosystem. Ecosystems which can be deployed and interact with the users and perform actions on the behalf. Generally, Google bot and the Siri bot are the informational bots. Okay, these bots are only contains a knowledge in nature, and then able to interact with the users. It can be helped with assistance. Will eventually invoke the bots to domain specific work. Next, introduction of bots and benefits. Bots are generally now bots are exposed now. We can develop a bot in Google called a Dialogflow model. I can show you the demo of the Dialogflow model, then you can understood. The Dialogflow model from the Google is a bot platform ecosystem. It is just a framework. And then we discuss about, and then we define the behavior of the bot, like Google Assistant bot had some characteristics and the Siri bot had some characteristics based on the security concerns. So we can define that characteristics in bot distinctions. These are the benefits of the bot, major benefits of the bot nowadays. Keep up with the trends. Generally, Twitter and Messenger engaged nearly millions of bots to engage with the users. And then it helps to improve the customer services and customer engagement and the monitoring and gaining the insights. This one helps for more engagement of the Google Analytics, not only Google Analytics, for analytic perspective. And then a better lead generation and bouncing rate of the web applications or mobile application. And then we can approach easier into the global market. At last, cost saving. Cost saving means literally we can tell as a TCO, total cost ownership is less compared to others. These are the major benefits of the using the bot. And next one is the introduction of the good bot and how it works. Generally, we are mostly facing the good bot and the bad bot also. In good bots are, we all know the chat bots and crawlers. Chat bots is just a Google, like a Google Assistant and Siri. Like these are the chat bot, or we can go to the any web application, there is a bot, a person can speak with you, or a bot can speak with you and interact with some other person with the company. And next one is the crawlers. Crawlers is a very good bot because these are called web spiders. I think those people know about the web spiders. It can make an index of the web page, web application to the search engine like Google and Bing. Google and Bing has own bot called Google bot and Bing bot. And transactional bot, this is a very recently popular bot. A transactional bot is just it enhances and provide a services to the external application, like third party applications, and make a data transfer with it. And the next one is the informational bot. Information bot is just had a knowledge in nature, like a Siri and Siri, they are chat bots. Information bots is means if you go to the web application, a bot can know something. Okay, these are the information bot. It can know, these are domain specific bots. I can tell domain specific bots. And entertainment bots are gaming bots. Many games have a bot. It can play as a opposite team, but it can virtually, we can virtually feel like a person can play with it. These are a bot. And bad bots are hackers, spammers, and scrappers, and impersonators. These are, we are facing when you download some application or some file in torrent, it redirect to some other pages. These are the bad bots, general examples of the bad bots. And next one is how bot could be a successful computing platform. Generally, there are five paradigms are considered to be a successful computing platform. Those are the software foundation contains a rich set of API. And next one is the community developers who can contribute to the software or foundation. And next one is the distributions. Generally, we call it as distros. It can reach the multiple devices. And next one is the monetization. How can we monetize by developing applications or bots by using the software foundation? And next one is how can we retail the content? Like I can set you an example. Drupal is a simple example for the successful computing platform because it had a good stable releases and it had a good community. It had a good distros. And it is free, but we can develop our distributions and we can monetize this and make a retail of that content. Similarly, bot has evolved like this. These are the computing success. These are the example of the successful computing platform, or I can tell it is a architecture or it is a standard for to be a best computing platform. The bot can act as interim between the content creation point and the content distribution control point. Here, software foundation like a platform APIs, software foundation, developer ecosystem, monetization, distributions, and retailing are the ingredients to the successful computing. In the successful computing, how the product success factors has been calculated by using how it has been managed in a fragmented manner and how it has been actively participate in the community and how it has been ubiquitous in manner and how it has been large addressable market. And the next one is the personalized discovery of applications. And next one is how it can tackle its competencies. That's the main thing. These are the standards for the successful computing platforms. These are the examples of the these are the example bots which can sustain the verticals and the dynamics of the bot platform ecosystem. Generally, we know most of the things, right? WeChat we know, and Facebook Messenger, Microsoft Skype, Skype, Microsoft Skype is recently introduced, but and Telegram is recently introduced, and Slack bot and Facebook Messenger and WeChat are in earlier stage. They are the pioneer for this. And next one, we got introduction of the Drupal 8 and the Google bot dialogue flow. Generally, dialogue flow is a Google AI bot. It is a Google AI platform which helps to create a bot without code. We don't need to write a code for simple things. If you go to IBM Watson or some other bot, means we need to write a code for this. Generally, dialogue flow is a natural language processing model. It is a conversational platform which can interact with the user by using some configuration intents. Why the dialogue flow is most popular means because if I go to develop a bot for the Facebook Messenger, means I can use only for the Facebook Messenger. If I go to develop a bot for Slack, means I can do only for Slacks. But if I develop a bot using the dialogue flow, I can integrate those into all, for Messenger, for Slack bots, and any interfaces. I can integrate those. These are the dialogue flow process pipelines. In dialogue flow process pipelines, it had certain factors like intents. Intents means just user utterances. What the user will be, what the user import, and how the dialogue flow has to provide output. It had some pipelines like context, events, actions and params, response and fulfillment. In context, it is just user utterances, and events means what events when trigger for this input. And actions and params means these are the dynamic values. If you are handle the dynamic value, means we have to give actions and params. Responses and fulfillment means in fulfillment is just to log the data. In responses means for this context, for this event, for this intent, what is the responses? So these are the implementations of the bot with the Drupal. Generally, an user in the Drupal application, a user can provide a input. That is a user-based preferred utterances or actions, and then intents. Intents are just intentional user intention words. It's intents, and then process means this is dialogue flow process pipelines. In the process, we already know context, events, actions and params, responses and fulfillment. Then we can integrate with webhook responses, and then webhook responses, we trigger the event in the Drupal application. We implemented in the process flow, we are not implemented in the webhook integrations. These are the actual workflow in this model. In the Drupal application, a user can ask a bot to create a node. In the bot, ask us which node type you want to create. Then we have tell us a basic page. Then it has been redirected to the page. Basic page on the basic page as an entity and the node as an entity. Creation page. The same process will be for all the Drupal configurations and the content entities. Then it is what are the achievement is it provides a more realistic compared to the other bots, and self improvement capabilities in dialogue flow we have to pay for that. These are free. These are the complex phases in implementation because we can't find the intent naming for all the user intention, and we cannot change the existing process in the chatbot using the dialogue flow, and we cannot leverage the existing data in the dialogue flow, and the format flow complexities are there, and then ML model non-determinization means we have to employ the machine learning phase and the TensorFlow phase or the deep learning phase to learn better the Drupal application, because it helps to content editors to put their content. It just navigate the content editors for this create a node like a basic page means you just command them, it just navigate to the that page, they put their content. The content editors no need to know about the navigations. these are the significance of this presentation, this idea. And then and these are the feature works. If it continues, means because we are working on this, if it next we are planning to, it is only for now, currently it is works only for end user and the editors or content editor, content providers. Now a Drupal developer can use this bot. A Drupal developer can develop a Drupal application using this bot. And the main phase is the bot can work for a developer. This is the main phase. And it can integrate with it. And the next phase is it can integration with the Drupal application for continuous integration, continuous deployment. Means a bot can do all the things when he commands, when developer commands to the bot. And next is it has to be improvises the content editor's workflow as well as the Drupal developer workflow. So now I show you a demo. Next, in Drupal Chennai, we had an event on December 7 or 8. We are the volunteers. We welcome you all. So I show you a demo. This is the Drupal bot. This is the Drupal application. We are integrating the dialog flow context. Wait. This is the dialog flow interface. In that interface, we had a intent named default welcome intent. In that intent, we specify the welcome message. These are the training. In the training phases, we provide what are the user will ask. What are the user utterances will be. For hi, he will call as just going to say hi. We just provide a general training for the bot, and then we provide a responses here. Here, these are the responses when you ask these type of questions. It will reply like this. These are the three intents we are created. In that intent, this is the welcome note. This is the fallback note. Fallback intent means it just it doesn't know the correct intent. Means it just show like exceptions, and it is the default Drupal welcome intent we are just now created. If I go there. Just to provide a reply only. That's where implemented. That's it. Thank you.